गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट। तो इन प्रीवियस क्लास सॉल्व क्वेश्चन के लिए नाउ द क्वेश्चन नंबर 9। क्लासिफाई द फॉलोइंग नंबर्स एज अ रेशनल और इरेशनल। तो एज वी नो वी टॉक अबाउट द डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन एज वी डन अर्लियर। There are different type of decimal expansion. First of all, if we talk about terminating, like a half, if we divide, we get a 0.5, the decimal expansion, and as a terminating. If we talk about non-terminating, like a 10 by 3, if you divide, try to divide, you will get a 3, 3, 3, 3. That means 3 decimal 3 bar. Next month, recurring. Suppose I take a same example, 10 divided by 3, you will get a 3 decimal 3, 3 and continue. When the number repeats itself, that is called recurring. Recurring means repeat. So, 10 by 3 is non-terminating and recurring. 10 by 3 is non-terminating and recurring. Next one is a non-recurring. Like a root 2, 1.4142, and continue we get a number in decimal expansion, but never you will get a same number. So that is called non-recurring. That means a number is not repeating itself. Okay, so if we talk about a number which are non-terminating and non-recurring, the number which are non-terminating and non-recurring is called a irrational number, and rest number are known as a rational number. Okay, so here we have to just classify rational and irrational number. Only the number which are non-terminating and non-recurring is known as irrational, and other numbers are known as rational number. Okay, so move to the question now. The first one, root 23. Try to find out a root value of 23. We get that it is a non-terminating and a non-recurring. We get around 4 point something. So number is not repeating and you will never get an end. That means you never get a zero as a remainder. So it is a irrational number. Next one, root 225. So root 225 is the value of 15. If you multiply 15 by 15, you will get a root. If you multiply 15 by 15, you will get a 225. So 15 is not a irrational number. So it is a rational number. Next one. 0.3796. Here you can see there is no dots are given. That means the 6 is the last quotient. That means it is a terminating. So it will be a rational number. Next one, you can see 7.478 and 478. These are repeating itself. So even you can say that it is a 7.478, and you can draw the bar. Non-terminating, that means the number is repeating itself and it is a recurring. So it is again a rational number because the numbers are repeating itself. And last one, in last you can see the dots are given. That means you will get a continuous quotient. and number is not repeating itself. It is 10, it is 100, it is 1000, it is 10,000. Next time we get a 1 lakh. So it is a different one. So again, it is a irrational number. Okay. So when the numbers are non-terminating and non-recurring, that is known as irrational number, and rest number are rational number. Okay. So the next one is representing a real number on number line. If we go by the example, visualize the representation of 5 decimal 37 bar. This is a bar only above the 7, not above 3. Okay, that means 7 will repeat on the number line up to a 5 decimal. You have to mark the number on a number line up to a 5 decimal places, and that is up to 5 decimal 37777. Okay, so after decimal there are the 5 digits. So now you have to represent the number 5 decimal 3 and 4 times 7 on a number line. Okay, so we will draw only a line which part that we need. A line that means in both sides there should be an arrow. Okay, suppose there is a 5 and there is a 6. Why? Because we know that the 5 will be in between 5 and 6. So now as we know, between two integers there are ten equal parts on a number line. So if we divide, suppose there are 10 part in between 5 and 6. So if we divide after 5, it will be a 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, 5.3, 5.4, 5.5, 5.6, 5.7, 5.8, 5.9, and that is 6. Decimal 0 you can write. So now, where is your number? You can see that your first number after the decimal is 3. But after 7, 3 it is a 7. So your number will be in between.
First of all, you have to complete
5.3. You will complete the 5.3 and then you will move to the 5.37. The number 5.37 will be in between 5.3 and 5.4. So now it is not visible, that's why we will magnify it. That means we will zoom in using a magnifying glass. For question, we have to just draw a bigger. So next one. Now we know our number is in between 5.3 and 5.4. So now we will zoom that part only. Suppose there is a 5.3 and that is a 5.4. So after 5.3 there will be a 5.31. Nothing is known, that means it is a 5.30. After that, 5.32, then 5.33, 5.44, sorry, 5.34, then 5.35, 5.36, 5.37, 5.38, 5.39, and 5.4. Okay, you can write a 0. Yes. So we zoom only that part after 5.32, 5.4. So after 5.3 to 5.4, that is the zoomed part. So now we talk about the 5.37. So where is the 5.37? It is the 5.37. But after 5.37 you have to move 5.37 and again 7. So first of all we have to complete 5.37 and then again we have to divide that part into a 10 equal part. So after 5.37 we will get a 5.371, 5.372. So same like this one. Now we have to zoom that part only. 5.372, 5.38. We will zoom it again and draw the same one. So 5.37. After 7, it will be 1. Now 5.372. It will be a 5.373. It will be a 5.374. It will be a 5.375. 5.376. 5.377. 5.378. 5.379. And it will be a 5.380. Okay. So what we need? We need a 5.377. So where is your number? First of all, you completed 5.37. So after 5.37, this is again 7. So 5.37 is 1 and we have to move till 7. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So that is your 5.377. But after that 7, this is again 7. So again we have to divide 5.377 to 5.378 into the 10 equal parts. So these are the 10 equal parts. It is not visible. Then again we have to magnify it and let me zoom it. So again we have to draw the number line and divide the other 10 divided equal parts. 5.377. After that there will be a 1. So this is a 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and after that 0 and we have to add 1, that means it is a 80. So again you have to start from there, 5.377, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, it is your 7. But after 3 times 7, again there is a 1 more 7, so your number will be in between 5.377 to 5.378. So again you have to magnify that part. So again you have to draw one more number line. So I am rubbing the upper part and that will be your last part. Okay. So if we zoom this part, so as we know they are the 10 equal parts, and then we zoom in, then we will get this one. After 5.3777, after this one you will get a 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then last one is 80. So if you again start with the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and that is your answer. What do you need? 5 decimals, 3 and 4 times 7. So that is your answer. 5 decimal, 3, 7, 7, 7 and 7. Okay. So you have to draw almost 4 or 5 number lines to complete for the question from exercise 1.4. Okay. So thank you.